As the Ruby Mountains and East Humboldt Range were being excavated, if you like, toward the surface on these very deeply penetrating crustal fault zones, at deep levels, rather than breaking, the rocks deform ductally. And here in Secret Creek Gorge, they form a kind of rock called Mylonite that comes from the Greek origins of the word, mean to mill. And around the 1970s, scientists began to recognize that that image of milling or grinding was not appropriate for these rocks, that they actually were metamorphically recrystallizing, but recrystallizing to a finer and finer grain size. These Mylonites here in Secret Creek Gorge were a critical part of the history of coming to understand the origins and how to interpret Mylonites. And internationally famous geologist, structural geologist Gordon Lister refers to this area as the Mylonite Museum of the Cordillera. And we're seeing really some of the most spectacular Mylonites that we see anywhere in the Cordillera, or really anywhere in the world. And what we see here is some folding, but what you are folding here, you can see the layers are folded completely over on themselves. And that layering that is being folded is itself this incredibly intensely deformed myelinitic layering. Intermixed here are some black, flinty-looking layers that we know as ultramyelinite. And effectively, this process called dynamic recrystallization, that is recrystallization but under extreme stresses, has here proceeded to its kind of end extreme example. And you get some places where the grain size has been reduced so far that you can't even resolve it with a microscope. You would have to go to an electron microscope. So what this is showing us is that this was a progressive process. You have the myelinitization forming the foliation, and then that foliation is itself refolded. Sometimes you get these bands of ultramyelinite that are then become more rigid and get stretched out or bunaged and spun around and refolded. And it's just one of the most spectacular examples that I know of anywhere on Earth to study these rocks.